Good morning. Half eaten up by mosquitoes. And blue skies. Slept at a rest area? No. No, I could not have. There's no way of pulling a Super B down that. Nope. So yeah, last night and today morning, I mean, just swarms of mosquitoes. Just swarming around. Thousands of mosquitoes. I jumped out and jumped in, kept that door closed as much as possible. Grabbed a mosquito coil and burnt it in here for a few seconds. We're only supposed to use those outside, but just burnt it inside here just a few seconds. Get a little bit of smoke inside again. Get the mosquitoes in here, kill them. Spot like this in the cab, you only need a few seconds to get enough smoke in here to get rid of the mosquitoes. Because if you let it burn, you'll kill your lungs. And yeah, they're not designed for inside. Of course, no rain today, which means I'm getting splatted by all these mosquitoes. The windshield's getting filled with bugs. Oh well. You always know when you're getting close to Prince George. We're about half an hour out. We're not going to actually drive through Prince George because the lumber mill I'm going to is on the south end of town. We're coming in from the east. You can bypass the city, quite easily. So we'll bypass the city. You always know you're getting close to Prince George when mountains disappear and all you see is trees, more trees. I'll fuel up as well before going to Chipper. I'm not scheduled to be there until afternoon because, well, dispatch didn't think I was going to deliver that load yesterday either, so they've got me scheduled till afternoon. So I'm going to show up anyway around 8 or so, I guess. And just acknowledge the fact that, hey, I'm really early. I'll just sit on the side here until you're done with the appointments that you guys have. If you can sneak me in somewhere, great. If not, that's okay. And sometimes you get loaded earlier than your appointment. Very often, most of the time you get loaded earlier if you come in with a good attitude. pretty good. I might set up a second camera. I'll try to remember to do that when I grab the load. I'll set up a second camera, see if we can capture. I set up a GoPro mount on the mirror so I can face it backwards. Maybe catch him loading us. I'll do that. Saying his last words, I'll forget. I guess I really don't need the second camera for that. I'll just take this camera and put it up there. Turn it in reverse and see what we get. At this location, I'm not allowed to be outside the truck while they're loading. A lot of locations are like that. Actually, some locations you're not allowed to be in your truck while loading. You have to go stand in front of your truck while being loaded. They don't want you in the truck. They don't want you anywhere beside the truck moving around. They want you standing at the front end of the truck. On the driver's side, so they can see where you are, what you're doing. And of course, you gotta try to remember all these rules for every place. Most safety rules are the same. The only safety rules that really change from location to location is where they want you when they're loading or unloading. Some places don't have much at all for safety rules. They let you walk underneath the bundle while they're loading it. It's like, are you insane, driver? Why would you walk underneath there?
No, you got it. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Man, I didn't even have time to set up a camera properly. That's why the first camera was so shaky. Let's get out of here. No waiting at all. Just pull in, go. Here's your paperwork. Pull on in. Whew. Go, go, go. So here the rules are, you're only allowed to strap down the trailer they're not working on. So as soon as he's got the front trailer loaded, I look at the forklift driver and he makes a motion of, yes, go ahead, tie down. So I start throwing straps for the front trailer. Get that all strapped down while he loads the back trailer. And then once all the belly straps are down, while I'm strapping the back trailer, he loads the extra bundles on the front trailer and vice versa. You keep going around. You guys didn't get to see me throwing the straps. You guys obviously only saw loading one side. I do have a plan putting a camera on the other side as well sometime. Future plans. So hopefully you guys like that. The last strap, I waited to strap down and you saw me crouch down. I was waiting for the chipper to come and scan the product on the other side. Oh, he must be overweight. He's coming back. Oh wait, he's only got a lead on there. Strange. I don't know what's going on. Very strange. Maybe just doing transfers or something. Oh, pup is parked over here. So he dropped the pup. I'm confused. Normally I take a right-hand turn here, but every now and then we take a left-hand turn. Means gravel roads. Left-hand turns means gravel road. Haven't gone this way in a long time. It's been rainy slash, so the roads have probably got lots of puddles on them and potholes, and might be a rough road, but every now and then I like taking the other way out.
In 400 meters, turn left on Dams Road.
No, Garmin, I can't turn off on Dams Road. That's a weight-restricted road. Road. Speed limit on this road is 80. All unmarked roads, gravel roads like this, in British Columbia, the maximum speed limit is 80. In Manitoba, the maximum speed limit was 90 on roads. So for a longest time in BC, I was doing 90 on roads like this.
5 kilometers, turn right on Highway 97.
Looks like they graded it recently, so it's nice and smooth. I mean, it's bumpy, but sometimes it's really, really bumpy. Oh, was talking about? Oh yeah, kneeling down. I was waiting for him to scan the barcodes on the other side, because if I tightened that last strap, it would cover the barcodes. So let him scan the stuff in first before tightening that strap. So, I should make it to Kelowna tonight. I'll be close. Maybe not. Well, maybe. Yeah, I have the GPS set with load. I thought I had it set empty, so I have it set with a load, so yeah, I might make Kelowna tonight. Now, what time will my appointment be tomorrow? I don't know. It might be after lunch, so I might sit around. Gravel roads like this, no marked signs for curve coming up and how tight the curve is. So if you're going to drive along the road pretty quick, you better know exactly how tight the corner is. I guess it doesn't look too bad, but once you get to the corner, it's like, whoa! Luckily, I've got a GPS that tells me it's a fairly tight corner. Flashing lights, I don't see a train either. Alright, thanks for driving straight into the sun, so I'll catch up with you guys along on the road somewhere. Nope, turn the music off, turn the music off. Quinnell scale here. I stopped half an hour, ran across the yard here and grabbed some lunch at the A&W. Felt like a warm meal and I didn't feel like making it. As a rule, I don't stop more than once a week at a fast food or a restaurant. The rest of the meals are homemade or sandwiches or...
Turn left on Caribou Highway.
Okay. Now the A&W parking lot has enough space to go park in there as well. But if I have to pull over for the scale already anyway... Wow, that looked funny with a small little pup behind the truck. Yeah, if I have to pull over for the scale anyway, I must just park in the scale parking lot and walk to the A&W. Beautiful day. Since I had no cell service last night, I spent the half hour going through all your comments on the YouTubes. Thanks for all those. I really enjoy the comments. Excuse me. Short ones, the long ones, the really long ones, I love them all. Just fun to read them all. I think it's just me knowing I'm sharing the ride with other peoples across the world. Because I really enjoy watching videos from other parts of the world as well, just because, well, if you've never been there, you don't know what it's like. So watching video, I know it's not the same as being there, but it kind of gives you a little glimpse of the area. I feel full. Yeah, lunch was at 10:30 in the morning. But when you start at 6 a.m., 10:30 in the morning isn't that early for lunch. fact, maybe that's even late for lunch. I order a big Papa Burger and poutine. If you guys have never had poutine, oh, you guys have no idea what you're missing. Poutine is so good. Having said that, this is fast food poutine. It's not the good stuff, the really good stuff. I remember getting poutine in Quebec City. Best poutine I have ever had. Is it poutine or poutin? If you don't know what poutine is French fries. Squeaky, well, most of the time, these fast food places, these cheese curds are not squeaky, but if you can get them fresh, like in Quebec City, where the cheese curds are squeaky, every bite you take, you feel it in your teeth squeaking. Just so good. So you got French fries with cheese curds mixed in. The hot French fries melt all the cheese curds. And then hot gravy. Hot gravy dumped over top of. So basically, French fries, gravy, and cheese curds. And a lot of fast food joints now sell poutine all over Canada. 10 years ago, you couldn't find poutine. In the western part of the country. Now that fast food joints are selling them, you can get poutine everywhere. Yeah, let's weed the flowers and we'll just throw all the weeds on the road. I'm guessing they've got a sweeper coming by later. Quesnel, nice little town. I couldn't live down in the bowl here. I think I've talked about that before, but I'd have no problem living just outside of the bowl or outside of the valley here on the top, away from the pulp mill smell. And most days it's not bad smell, but every now and then it just stinks in town. The wind just right.
In 400 meters, turn left on Caribou Highway.
Seen a lot of empty aero trucks headed north, and as you guys saw when I was loading, there were aero trucks loading over there.
Turn left at the traffic light.
Old Fraser River bred here. Fraser River Bridge would have been an old single lane bridge back in the day. Never gone to the other side of the river. Looks like there's quite a bit of town on that side of the river too. The bridge is closed. The sign was up there last time coming through.
In 400 meters, turn left on Davie Street.
Can't take a big rig over that bridge anyway, but Trust me, I've tried. Pulled into the off the road there and it's like, oh, weight restrictions on the bridge. It'd be nice if you put those weight restrictions before you turned off.
Turn left on Davy Street.
Slowly moving. Only one engine on this end. So I don't know if this is the back of the train. Our pickup was right behind us and he's waiting here at the light. There's two different ways to come through town there. It's a lot of floating. I don't know what you call that. What do you call that? All the trees bloom. My brain is not registering. My brain's not working. All the white fluff floating around. It's called something. And there's a lot of it. Anyway, I'll catch up with you guys down the road somewhere. There's more Quesnel at the top, but I've gone through Quesnel lots of times with video on, so if you guys haven't seen the top or the south end of the town, there's a video somewhere down below that does show the whole town. I don't know where. It's probably not called Quesnel, but it's down there. Whoa. Line just goes straight into the ditch. Just a cube van. Looked like there was police tape on it already, so. I always look for the police tape. If there's police tape on it, someone's checked out the vehicle. If there's no police tape on it, wouldn't hurt if you pulled over, stopped, and checked out the vehicle yourself. But yeah, it looked like he just, I don't know, fell asleep, or the lines are just straight into the ditch. That driver must take that corner often because he took it at full speed. Must be a restaurant down there. That company basically brings restaurant food to everybody. It's important to stop early if you're tired. I did that this week. I stopped early. Stopped a solid hour early because I'm like, you know what? I'm tired. Don't want to look for... That was when I slept near Kamloops there a couple of days ago. Could drive another hour, but I'm tired. I think I'll just stop now. Pulled over at the next pullout and slept there. did it hinder me down the road? Well, last night I was about 50 minutes short of making it to Prince George. So if I had not stopped early, I could have gone to Prince George and seen my family. So sure, stopping early has consequences, but not stopping early could be much, much, much worse. I might never see the family again. So if you're tired, don't pressure yourself. Don't let your boss pressure you. If you're tired, pull over and sleep. Another trick that works sometimes for me, I still have plenty of drive time and I don't want to sleep yet. I feel like I'm getting a bit tired. I pull over and I run around the truck a couple times to get the blood pumping and then jump in the truck and drive. I still feel tired, then I pull over and sleep, but most of the time getting the blood pumping does a good trick. It's a police truck. Ghost SUV. Trying to get some speeders coming down this hill, I guess. Yeah, no load is more important than your life or somebody else's life. We drive big trucks. Very likely we're going to survive the accident, but the minivan you just hit, will they survive? Not worth it. Just stop the truck. Time to roll down into Williams Lake. Getting a little cloudier out there. I don't know. Can't really tell.
Okay.
Four and a half kilometers.
Turn left
on Highway 97.
Hello, General Santa.
VHF is busy here. they're doing there.
Go ahead.
I'll back up and then catch it and get up there.
Quite a few lumber mills, and most of the radio chatter is different lumber mills talking. Some of the chatters from construction crews as well. Peterbilt coming up there. Let's see if we can leave him some momentum. If the car had done the same thing, he could have kept a lot more momentum. Make it up the hill a little better. Through much of Williams Lake, it's just kind of barely dip into one corner of the town.
cold bomb.
Whenever you get around lumber mills, if you turn the VHF on and just hit the scan button, you'll get quite a bit of chatter, but other than that, VHF is not used much. CB radio has been on this whole time. Every video, I just leave the CB radio on, and you guys never hear anyone on that thing, ever. I'm on channel 19, CB radio, I just leave it there, and you never hear anything on that thing. When running in the US, you'll hear some chatter on it, either on channel 19 or 17, but CB radios, VHF, not used much anymore these days. The only time the VHF gets used is when you get close to lumber mills. Lumber mills use VHF a lot. That's the dude I allowed to have a little momentum up the hill. He's obviously got a little more horsepower. That first axle on the rear trailer is, that one tire or the one rim is wobbling quite a bit. Here comes the other Peterbilt. I turn VHF off because usually the language is quite vulgar on there, especially if you get closer to Vancouver. There's just no point. All it is vulgar and racist and people yelling at each other. There's no point of listening to that. And on the highways, every now and then you hear someone chat with them, but even then, it's not content I can put on a YouTube channel that's kid-friendly. Ah, he's going to Washington. Or she's going to Washington. Or she's from Washington, probably delivered a load up here. And
not a problem, guess you bet.
But usually when you get two towns with lots of lumber mills, the radios are pretty clean there. This week I've driven through the same parks and stuff, and not as much. Saw a couple of bighorn mountain sheep, saw a small herd of elk, and then deer and turkeys, that's about it. And of course Canadian geese with all their baby geese following them around, but yeah, no bears, no moose. Radio starting to get staticky. Turn the scan off and just leave it on LAD 1. Mile house here. Small little community. And I think I'll call it here. So thanks for watching. Hit the thumbs up if you enjoyed. Without Jess here, I seem to be shooting way more videos, so I've got way too much video editing to do this weekend. Way too much. Maybe if I have some time tonight, I'll do some editing tonight. Thanks again for all the comments. Thoroughly enjoyed reading those. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Since I'm going to be delivering first thing in the morning tomorrow in Kelowna, I wonder what they're going to give me for a load. Should be interesting. Anyway, guys, I'm out. Hit the stop record button once we're through this town, and then RCMP is parked pretty close to on the road there. Oh, another one over there. He's got a customer handing out souvenirs. People tend to blaze through here like at 100 kilometers per hour, speed limit 70 up here. Anyway, I'm out. Thanks again. Adios. I think the cloud patterns are spectacular today. that was Lac Le Hatch. Hundred Mile House.